गुड मॉर्निंग बेटा। यस्टरडे वी हैड स्टार्टेड विद द न्यू चैप्टर हीरोन्स फॉर्मूला। फर्स्ट एक्सरसाइज वी हैड कंप्लीटेड। नाउ लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द सेकंड एक्सरसाइज, दैट इज एग्जैक्टली सेम, नथिंग न्यू इज देयर। सो यू हैव टू यूज द सेम फॉर्मूला टू सॉल्व एक्सरसाइज 12.2। फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज Is it visible? Bhavansh, Divya. Okay. First question is a path is in the shape of a quadrilateral. Quadrilateral is given. A, B, C, D. This angle is 90. AB is 9. BC is 12. CD is 5 and AD is 8. How much area does it occupy? You have to find the area of this quadrilateral. What you will do is, you will actually, we are not having the formula for finding the area of the quadrilateral. So what you will do, you will find the area of this quadrilateral by dividing it into two parts. If you divide it into two parts, AB is given, BC is given, CD is given, and AD is given. How much area does it occupy? This is a right angle triangle. In case of a right angle triangle, you can apply Pythagoras theorem. So let's apply the Pythagoras theorem to find this diagonal. So if you have this diagonal, then you can find the area of the each triangle that is formed on either side of the diagonal by using Hieron's formula. Now, angle C is 90 degree. This implies right angle triangle by Pythagoras theorem. The side opposite to right angle is your hypotenuse. The side opposite to the right angle is your hypotenuse is equal to perpendicular square plus base square. Perpendicular is your hypotenuse is equal to perpendicular square plus base square. Hypotenuse is your BD and perpendicular and base are 12 and 5. So you can use them anyways. 12 square Now we want to find the area of these two triangles. This we have got as 13. Find the area of these two. In triangle BCD, by Hieron's formula, area is equal to under root S, S minus A, S minus B, S minus C. Now let's find this S, that is semi-perimeter. S is equal to A plus B plus C by 2, 5 plus 12 plus 13 by 2, 30 by 2, that is 15. Is it okay? So we have got, yes, Ridhima, on your video first. Ridhima, on your video. As we have got now, area one means area of this triangle, then we will find area of the second. That is under root 15, 15 minus 5, 15 minus 12, 15 minus 13, 10, 3, 2. Okay, now make the factors. 15 is 3, 5s are 15. 10 is 2, 5s are 10. 3 into 2. Out of these 3, 1, 3 will come out. Out of this 2 and 1, 5, 1 come out. That is 30 centimeter square. We have got the area of the first triangle. Now let's find the area of the second triangle by using this same formula. You can get the area of the another triangle. Is it okay? Now let's find the area of the second triangle by Heron's formula. Next is area of triangle. Area 2 means triangle ABD. Triangle ABD. We are finding the area of triangle ABD. That is given by under root. What will be the semi-perimeter of this? What will be the semi-perimeter of this triangle? That you will get by again using the same formula. This is A plus B plus C by 2. Let's use this formula again. And that you will use for the another triangle. You will again find S by using the same formula. S is equal to sum of these three, 8 plus 9 plus 13 by 2, that is 30 by 2, that is 15. Again 15. Area is 15, 15 minus 8, 15 minus 9, 15 minus 13. Three fives are 15, seven same. This is 3, 2. Area of the second triangle. Now we want to add these two to get the area of the quadrilateral. So area of quadrilateral. Six you can take out. Actually, area of quadrilateral is deleted from the syllabus. But we are finding the area of quadrilateral by adding the area of the two triangles, so that you have to do. Actually, earlier we were having one direct formula for finding the area of quadrilateral. But we can't use that direct formula, so that's why we are finding the area of quadrilateral by adding the area of the two triangles. So this you have to do. Yes.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Anji, bolo.
Ma'am, जब मैं नोट करी थी ना फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन तो बीच में स्क्रीन ब्लर हो गई थी तो ये दोबारा समझा दो कुछ दिख भी नहीं रहा
है एरिया निकाला है फिर हमने सेकंड ट्रायंगल का एरिया निकाला है जो हमने कल फॉर्मूला किया था हीरोन्स फॉर्मूला बिल्कुल सेम इससे लेकिन प्रॉब्लम ये थी कि डायगोनल आपको गिवन नहीं था थर्ड साइड तो वो ये राइट एंगल ट्रायंगल है पाइथागोरस थ्योरम से थर्ड साइड फाइंड कर ली जो आ गई 13 एंड दिस डायगनल इज एक्ट एज अ थर्ड साइड ऑफ द ट्राइंगल सो यू विल फाइंड द एरिया ऑफ द फर्स्ट फिगर देन सेकेंड फिगर फर्स्ट फिगर का एरिया निकाला फिर सेकेंड फिगर का एरिया निकाला दोनों को एड करके दैट इज गिविंग यू द एरिया ऑफ द क्वाड्रिलेटरल एबीसीडी मेन थिंग इज दिस कि आपने थर्ड साइड कैसे फाइंड करना ये मेन है सेकेंड क्वेश्चन इज एग्जैक्टली सेम दैट यू विल डू एज योर होमवर्क आई एम नॉट डिस्कसिंग एग्जैक्टली दिस सेम टाइप ऑफ क्वेश्चन फाइव साइड्स आर गिवन सो यू विल फाइंड द एरिया ऑफ द फर्स्ट ट्रायंगल देन सेकेंड ट्रायंगल देन यू विल एड Third question we will do at the end of this exercise. Let's start with question number 4. Any doubt in this first question? Now, question number 4 is a parallelogram is given. A parallelogram is given and a triangle is given. If the sides of the triangle are 26, 28 and 30, ये triangle है, इसकी side है 26, 28 और 30. कहता same 28 वाली side पे एक parallelogram आ रहा है. Means parallelogram and triangle are sharing the same base 28 centimeter. This figure can be formed in this way also. Triangle can be formed inside or it can be formed on the opposite side. So both are same. You can go for any type of the figure, but the answer is same. Now, the thing is, you have given, if the side of the triangle are given and the parallelogram is standing on 28 centimeter base, find the height of this parallelogram. ये जो आपका parallelogram बन रहा है ना, इसकी height निकालनी है. ये height यहाँ पर भी बना सकते हो आप. ये height यहाँ पर भी बना सकते हो. Height, actually the height between the two parallel line is same everywhere. If you draw two parallel line, then the perpendicular distance between the two parallel line is same everywhere. So you can draw perpendicular here or outside the figure or from this point as well. So it depends upon you how you want to start. So the main thing is we are using one result if the triangle or parallelogram are on the same base and lying between the same parallel line, then the area of the triangle and the area of the parallelogram is same. Got it? Actually, this thing is given. Ki area jo hai, wo dono ka same hai. Now, sides are given. A is given as 26 centimeter. B is 28. Let's find semi-perimeter. Now in this question, it is given that area of triangle is same as area of parallelogram. Area of parallelogram. Area of parallelogram is base into height and area of triangle is under root s minus a s minus b s minus c. This thing is given. Now s is your 42, s is your 42 here. Base is 28 and height is h that we are finding. Now solve this. 42 ko minus karke kya aayega? 16, 14, 12. Is it okay? So I have just factorized the numbers in the root and I have taken out. Now we want to find h. H is given by, now let's cancel it out then. 4 2s are 4 7s are 7 6. H we are getting as 12 centimeters. So height of the parallelogram is 12 centimeters.
And your voice is not coming.
And your voice is not audible.
No, my voice is not.
Ma'am, no, baby, nahi hai.
Ma'am, no. Not audible. No, ma'am. No ma'am.
नहीं मैम अभी भी नहीं आ रही.
Yes Aryan.
जो आपने लिखा area of triangle is equal to area of parallelogram मैम वो कैसे?
दिया हुआ है. Read the question. They are standing on the same base. They have same area.
मैम third question नहीं करना?
करेंगे. That we will do at the end of this exercise.
Okay, ma'am.
Question number 5 is a rhombus shaped field has green grass for 18 cows to graze. Means the grass that is growing on this field is sufficient for 18 cows. If each side is 30 and diagonal is 48, how much area will each cow be getting? Now you have given three sides of the triangle and all the sides of each, both the triangles are same. So let's find the semi perimeter, that is A. Area of triangle, give it name. Fifty-four minus thirty. this 14 and 14 I have written same because they are exactly same. And this we have factorized. 27 twos are 54, 3 twos are 6. Now, 3, 2, and 14. Nine eights are 72, 18, 18 plus 7, 25. So this is the area of the one triangle. Area of rhombus is, how you will find area of rhombus? That is double of this because both are same. Area of rhombus. Now this area is sufficient for 18 cows to graze. Area for 18 cows, 504. Area for one cow, that's it now. Divide this. What you will be getting? Check your answer, what you are getting. Some mistake is there. We are not getting the correct answer. Why? S54 correct. Have you noticed one thing? This is 24. What you will get? 432. Double is 864. So each cow has this much area for grazing. Any doubt, beta? Anything you want to ask? So tomorrow, I think, or we'll take maybe one more day. So this much time it will take to finish the chapter. then we will start with the new chapter.